you are coding on Windows, I show you all the tricks I use to triple my productivity. And if you use Linux but you are still here because you want to put a funny comment, I got you. But go ahead, I can't wait to read them all. I have tricks, shortcuts and some extremely useful programs, like this search, that actually works. I'll show you the fastest way to navigate and multitask around your PC and be a better power user like me. This video will cover everything there is, so you don't have to search for another one after it. And I'll save you from a lot of headaches, so stick till the end to not miss anything. First of all, you can make Windows faster by debloating it. This means cleaning it of unnecessary stuff, and trust me, there is a ton of it. I leave a link in the description with instructions, and I also recommend searching for Windows optimization guides on YouTube. Just make sure you have a backup before messing with it, because there's always a 1% chance of breaking your Windows when doing stuff like that. And also, I use this software that allows me to force uninstall any program, including Edge. So that's cool, but don't uninstall Microsoft Store, because it will remove all the things that come with it, and you need some of them. Now, the first thing I always do is to make the taskbar small and hidden. And I know some people might not like some tips that I give here, but give them a try for a few days so you can make an educated decision. The advantage of having the taskbar hidden is that you are always on full screen. And don't worry, if you are used to having programs here and clicking them with your mouse, we don't want to do that anymore. I'll show you a way faster way of doing that without even touching your mouse. So also remove them from now. You'll see why later. Okay, this is a good start, but now let's learn some shortcuts. I'll show you many, so don't worry if you can't remember them all. I just want you to be aware that they exist. I'll write them down in the description, and you can just come back to this video later to refresh your memory. So, Ctrl-Shift-Escape will open the task manager, and F2 can rename a file. You can even rename multiple files at the same time. And F11 usually makes things full screen. But now, we get into the Windows key shortcuts. So, the Windows key has a shortcut with almost any button. I'll show you the ones I use. So, just the Windows button will bring up this thing. But it is useful because you can search for things here. Searching for files doesn't really work, and I'll show you a replacement for that, but searching for a program to open it is way faster than clicking it. If you can't find a program, that's just a Windows moment. So find where it is installed and make a shortcut of it on desktop. You only have to do this once, so don't worry. And once you have your programs opened, Windows plus the corresponding number of that program in the taskbar will minimize or maximize that window. You are still not convinced? Well, Windows E will open the File Explorer, that can't ever be slower than clicking it with your mouse. And on Windows 10, Windows W will open the drawing tool. And speaking of drawing, Windows Shift S will do a print screen for you. Windows P will bring the second screen settings, Windows A will bring these settings, and Windows N will bring the notifications panel. Now, if you press Windows Alt R, it will start recording only the current window, and it will even stop the recording after you close the window. You can press Windows G to open the game bar to see the recordings, and Windows Plus will bring the magnifying tool, and this can be extremely useful for people like me that don't really have the sharpest vision. This is not all of them. I'll show you some bonuses later, but after this video, play around with pressing Windows Plus random button to find yourself all the shortcuts that there are. But now, the most important part. I think this is the fastest way to do multitasking. So first of all, I see people keep all their windows open on the same desktop and use Alt Tab to navigate between them. Look, these are usually all the windows that I have open while I work, and on two different screens. Good luck alt-tabbing that. Introducing virtual desktops. So, press the Windows tab to see your virtual desktop. And you can create new ones from here. Navigate through them, and move your apps around. But don't worry, we have shortcuts. Ctrl Windows D will create a new virtual desktop. And then, you can press Ctrl Windows, left or right arrows, to move through them. Or if you have a laptop, you can just use 4 fingers across your trackpad and move through them. Okay, now let's look at how this works in practice. I usually have 3 virtual desktops. In the first one, I open Firefox and Discord, and maybe on my second screen, a File Explorer window to look at some files. On the second desktop, I have my main task program that I'm working on. Right now, I'm editing this video, so it will be the editing software. Finally, on my last desktop, I have something else related to my task, like one or two file explorers opened to copy recordings from one place to another. Then, I could also add a fourth one, to open Visual Studio and OBS. So, if I want a file explorer, I can just press Windows E. If I want a specific program, I press Windows, type it out and open it. If I want to browse the web, I go all the way to the left, and you get the idea. And then, to return to my main task, I go to the right. This is way faster than alt-tabbing, because I don't have to search for a program. I just go to the desktop that I want, and it is already configured with the exact needed setup. If you have a laptop, you can swipe 4 fingers up and search for the desktop that you need or move things around. It's kinda fast. But don't leave yet, because I kept the best for last. Productivity Power Tools is a program made by Windows and it adds even more shortcuts. I leave you to discover them, but I use Windows C, which opens up a color picker, and Windows M, which opens a ruler. This is very useful for developers. Imagine debugging UI with this. Is your disk space full? Space Sniffer is a good boy that can help you detect what takes the most space on your PC. Next, have you ever wanted to delete or open a file, but it was opened by another program? Log Hunter can find what program keeps a file open, and it can close the program for you or delete the file. And finally, Everything is a search tool that actually works. It is extremely fast, and you can even use regexes, if you know them. I usually press Windows, type everything, and then I'm in business. And if you found these tricks useful, I also know tricks for speeding up your development in Visual Studio. So go check that video to learn them, and share this one with a friend. See you!